Have you ever looked at a scene you made in a game and you said, "Damn, I suck at level design"? Every game developer went through that, and after they find out that most of the time it's not the case that they suck at level design, it's because of lighting. Your scene looks bad or doesn't look complete because it's out of life. In fact, lighting is 50% of level design. In this video, I will be explaining the 4 types of 3D lights and lighting settings in order to make an amazing light map. And in the next one, we will go through light probes, so stay tuned. If we didn't meet yet, my name is Walid from Spectra Games and I'm an indie games developer. Just make sure to smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm, it really means a lot to me, and subscribe for more content about games development. Without further ado, let's dive in. So, when you have a static or non-moving light in a game, you have two options for rendering this light. You can render it the same as a dynamic light or real-time lighting mode. That means that you will feed it to the shader pipeline, which will calculate its effects on everything around it, every frame, on its way to the screen. This is obviously pretty expensive. Or the second way is to make a light map, and that means that the shader pipeline will calculate lights all around your static objects, and will make a light map in which it will store the lighting data. Here you will see an example of a light map in the screen, and every time that scene will be rendered, the shader will render the lights as in the light map. This way is not performance heavy since there's no lighting calculations going in the background. For console games you can use real-time lighting, but in mobile games I recommend you to use baked lighting. So, we have three types of 3D lights in Unity. First, a point of light is located at a point in space and sends light out in all directions equally. They are used for simulating lamps and other local sources of light in a scene. You can use them also to make a spark or explosion in your scene. Like a point light, a spotlight has a specified location and range over which the light falls off. However, the spotlight is constrained to an angle, resulting in a cone-shaped region of illumination. We also have directional light, which comes up in a scene per default. It's the best way to present sunlight in your scene. Directional light can be thought of as distant light sources which exist infinitely far away. And finally, an area of light is defined by a rectangle or a circle in space. Light is emitted in all directions uniformly across their surface area, but only from one side. This type of light can be shown only when you bake the light map, which we will do in a second. So, now we are gonna start making our scene ready in order to bake a light map in it. What you should know first is that a light map can be baked only in static objects, we can't bake it in a dynamic object. So, the first thing we are gonna need to do is to mark all the static objects in our scene as static. But before that, I'm gonna come here to this model, I have it here, that I created with Blender, and this sphere as a player. I'm gonna come to the model here that I created with Blender. I'm gonna come down and click generate light map UVs. Then I'm gonna click apply, just like this. And after that, after all the changes are saved, I'm gonna come here to the lighting, this map in our scene, and I'm gonna set it as static and contribute GI so the light can affect it. Just like this, and I'm gonna mark it reflection probe static also. So now it's marked as a static. What you can also do is come to the directional light, mark it as contributes GI like the scene, and reflection probe static also, and you come here to the mode, changes even to make mixed and baked, because real time is so performance heavy, so I'm gonna go with the mixed in this video. That's all for the settings you should change in your scene in order to make it ready for the light map. So now we are gonna show our lighting settings window. We are gonna come here, window, rendering, lighting, and I'm just gonna set it here, and we are gonna create new lighting setting just like this. I'm gonna call it lighting tutorial, just like this, and here it is, our lighting settings. Next, I'm gonna explain to you the lighting settings one by one, and we are gonna go back here so we can tweak ours and bake our light map. So first, make sure you deactivate auto generate here, because it's just gonna cause you some problems during your work. So the first thing here in our scene's lighting settings is baked global illumination. You have to check it if you want to bake a light map, and that's exactly what we want, so check this. In the lighting mode, we can choose between three choices, but shadow mask will be removed soon, so we won't use it. Bake indirect bakes the light map on static objects, but also calculates the lighting data on dynamic objects at the same time. Subtractive mode bakes the light on static objects and dynamic ones, but doesn't calculate anything during the gameplay, so it's less expensive than the other one. I'm gonna go with it. Here in the light mapper, if you have big scene, you should use progressive CPU. But you have small scene, you better use progressive GPU because it's faster than CPU, and I'm gonna go with this because I have a small scene here. If you choose this progressive updates box, the camera will focus on rendering just the parts that appears in it, so it takes less GPU. But I'm not gonna use it here because I want it to focus on everything since I have a small scene here. You better not check the multiple important sampling box because it might lead you to some noisy parts of the scene during the gameplay. Direct samples represent the quality of outdoor light maps. The more it is, the better the light map samples are. So I'm just gonna let it to 32 for now. Indirect samples represent the quality of indoor light maps. The more it is, the better the light map samples are. I'm just gonna set it to 256 for now. Environment samples represent the quality of mixed lights in the scene. The more it is, the better the mixed light samples are. I'm just gonna set it to 256 right now, just like this. Light probe sample multiplier controls the quality of light probe sample. The more it is, the better the light probe sample. I'm not gonna touch it right now since we are not using any light probes in this scene. Max bounces represent the maximum bounces of scene's light. The more it is, the more the light rays are bouncy. I'm just gonna set it to 4 in this example because I want it to bounce more. Min bounces represent the minimum bounces of scene's light. The more it is, the more light is bouncing. I'm gonna set it to 2 right now. Filtering filters the weird lights that the light mapper fails to calculate. You better keep it at auto. Light map resolution. The better it is, the more resolution the light map has. Start it with 10 pixels, then increment it depends on your scene. But when you change it, make sure to go to your model or map file that you imported, and under lightmap UV setting, change the main lightmap resolution to the same value. Then click apply. If you didn't do this step by step, the map will have some overlapping lighting textures and it's not gonna work well for you. Lightmap padding. Its value represents how many pixels are between UVs in your light map. If you had shadows that doesn't belong to a specific place in your scene, just increment this value a little bit and rebake the light map again, and it will solve your problem. But now, just let it onto. Max light map size controls the light map resolution. Of course, the higher it is, the more accurate shadows and lights in your scene are. I'm just gonna set it to 512 right now, because my scene is a little bit small, I mean too small, so it's a good value for me. Compressed light map. If you check its box, it will compress the size of your light maps. That's of course a so amazing feature, especially for mobile games, but after it, you will notice some details are missing from your light map. I recommend you to check this box if you are working on a mobile game. If you are working on a console game, it's not gonna make a big difference for you. Ambient occlusion. When you check its box and bake the light map, you will notice that it's added some contrasting shadows to the scene. That of course makes it look more realistic, but it takes more space and of course GPU. I'm just gonna check it right now. Directional mode. When you set it to directional, it will make the light map calculate all the details in your normal map, and it will show the light on them. But if you set it to non-directional, all the details of normal maps will disappear. This is a really good feature if you don't want to make a performance heavy game for mobile devices. For example, I'm just gonna set it to non-directional since I don't have any normal maps in my scene. Albedo boost controls the bounces of light on albedo maps. I'm just gonna let it as 1 right now. Indirect intensity. Increasing it will make the intensity of light higher. A very good feature for indoor scenes, but I'm not gonna play with it since I don't have an indoor scene. And finally, light map parameters will allow you to choose the quality of your light in a general way. I'm just gonna choose high resolution here. In the environment settings, we find that we can attach our skybox here and our sun sources here. They are already attached per default, but if you don't have them, you must attach them so the light of the scene can affect on your objects. We also can control the color of our shadows from here. I'm just gonna set it to black. If you don't want to use the color of your skybox, you can change it even to a gradient or a color. That's gonna allow you to change the color of your light in your scene just like this. I'm just gonna set it to the skybox because I prefer it over both. Here in the environment reflection, you can choose the source of reflection, even a skybox or a custom. If you choose the custom, you have to enter here a cube map and it will reflect it on your game objects. But I'm just gonna set it to a skybox now, and you can also choose the resolution. If you choose the skybox, you can increase the resolution. I'm gonna choose this, and then you can compress it or uncompress it, or give Unity the choice to compress it or uncompress it. It depends on the size and other stuff. You can also choose the intensity of your reflection, and you can choose the bounces of your reflection. If you want a fog in your scene, just check this box and the fog gonna appear in your scene. There's also some other stuff like the color and the mode and the density, but I don't recommend you to use this fog. Why? Because there's another way to make it using a visual effect graph, and I'm gonna make a tutorial about it soon. So don't use this and wait for the next tutorial, because that one looks so amazing than this. So we finished now our environment settings, our scene settings, and we explained it all. You are gonna make yours, and then we are gonna go to the bake light maps and we are gonna bake ours, but it's gonna take some time, so I'm gonna pause the video till it ends and I'm gonna be back with you to show you our finished results. So here we finished baking our light map. As you can see with me, it took 7 minutes and 4 seconds. This is the size of it, and compressed of course as we did in the scene settings. We are gonna open it the preview, and here you see our UVs on the texture. This is all our light settings here stored, and everything is looking good so far. As you can see, the post-processing bloom started affecting on the wall, and there's some ambient occlusion here and here, just like this. But as you can see with me here, this sphere, our player is not affected by light. Why? Because we didn't mark it as static. Our player is an object that should be moving, so we can't mark it as static. And if we didn't mark it as static, a baked light not gonna be affected on it. So what's the solution? In the next video, I'm gonna explain to you this light probe group that's gonna make the light effects on our player even if it's moving. So stay tuned. This is the end of this video, guys. I hope that it was helpful for you. If you made it till the end, I appreciate you so much. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Smash subscribe and hit the notifications bell, because I drop cool videos every single week and you don't wanna miss them. See you in the next one.